Last time on Chasing Atlanta.
I want to figure out where did I go wrong, where you gotta take all these opportunities and you gotta say yes to this, you gotta do that to that. So did I really have a brother?
If we would have tackled bullet point one, we would have never got to bullet point 27.
Bullet point number one would have never happened and we would have remained brothers, we wouldn't be here today.
Yes, did we have some misunderstandings? Yes, whatever, whatever. Did I feel like you did some shit? Yes. Did you feel like I did some shit? Yes, but you were my brother. You were not my friend, you were my brother.
I know y'all been seeing what's going on online. The girls cutting up, doing their lives. Girl, they don't show up to events, but they'll get on the live and get the carrying.
Get the carrying now.
Like, we all out here trying to grind and grow, and y'all bitches like to go below the belt real quick.
So, like, moments like this, like how you came today, and it was great energy, you supported me. These are the things that I wish we as a group could do. It's like, get together.
Everybody different, friend.
I have so much stuff that I'm worried about. Like, I'm still waiting on my results to know if anything is good and stuff like that.
What's going on with the court case?
Well, the court date is coming up. I've been trying not to think about it because the thought of going back is don't cry, friend.
I mean, it's just like, that's what makes me mad about the whole situation with Troy was, you know, you came there to support him, you know?
Wayne is going to be the reason you're going to be stuck.
I didn't attack you, Troy. You threw the bottle at me. It's sad that I got to do all this shit, come up with these records, just to let y'all know you hurt me. But I'm going to show you Miss Hollywood. You better watch your motherfucking step, shawty. You got to come off that high horse, baby. You struggling like me.
Talented rapper who has also become like a really good friend and sister girl. The people have been waiting and the people shall get what they've been asking for. All of the Twixt is here, y'all.
Hi, I'm Alonda, I'm the John Don. Bitch, I'm daddy, I'm the Sean John. Hoes get right cause I'm the wrong one. Cause bitch, I'm the blonde, the blondes have more guns. Oops, I mean that blondes have more fun. Bitch, I ball, go get your pom-poms. Get my chopsticks, go get my wontons. Cause bitch, I get money from here to Hong Kong. Oh, niggas wanna press me out? Niggas wanna flex now? Well, I'ma still here at my reptile. But tell that rap nigga stick to his connect pal. Tell his homeboy stick to his OnlyFans. Tell his roommate stick to the jackdap. See, I was gonna result in a throwing hands. So your boyfriend hit me on the cash app. Looking for the right price, I can move past that. Affleck duck niggas wanna see him. Me and Twixt hopping up the Aston Martin. Niggas calling this PM and Gina. I got a couple bad bitches on my visa. And a nigga ball harder than Vegeta. So I never hesitate when I shoot a bug. Cause I zap niggas quicker than computer love, bitch.
So I'm planning a zap EP that's going to consist of this song with their added vocals and verses. This is an Oliver y'all been wanting. Y'all been wanting a lifted Oliver. Y'all been wanting an Oliver that looks more expensive and that's spending money and that's doing. Y'all are getting the things, girl, okay? They have been waiting on me!
Hey, sister.
Hey, bitch, what's going on?
Nothing much. Bitch, you were supposed to be here to come to my video.
I'm sorry, bitch. I missed my flight in Miami. So, child, I don't leave until tomorrow. But I will be there tomorrow, though, for sure.
You sure?
I promise you I'll be there tomorrow because we got a lot of shit to talk about.
Like, what would happen?
You remember when I had one on this little rant the last time on Instagram or whatever?
Yes, the one I was trying to stay far away from.
And you remember when she kept telling everybody like she needed help to get out, or she wanted everybody to help her get out because she went to jail because of her boyfriend or some shit like that, right?
Right.
So girl, when I went on my rant the other day, and child, I just got some tea that was slipping to my DMs about Miss Kenneth.
You can't keep calling that lady Kenneth.
Why I can't be calling her Kenneth?
She's Kendra.
Okay, well, she was Kendra when I seen you this.
But you cannot say shit to nobody because...
I'm dropping this piece of information. I'm dropping this information on it when everybody get together.
Girl, no! Girl, no!
I got one more.
No!
Are you not reading these things?
It's...
Are you not reading these things?
So I'm just trying to figure out why you so upset.
No! This is when she got arrested last year?
Oliver, she done told people that I'm fake. I don't have no car. I don't have shit.
No, I'm Lauryn. No. No.
This is some meth. I don't even know where to begin. All this time, me and everyone in this group thought that Miss Kendra got arrested because it was someone else's fault who had drugs in the car. Now, right before my eyes, I'm seeing that mama got arrested because of things she did on her own account.
So I got a little gift for everybody.
Lauryn, please no.
She wanna be seen? She finna be seen all over Atlanta, period. I'm getting billboards. I'm gonna teach these girls how to leave me alone when I ain't bothering you. She lied to you. She lied to Dwayne, even know the truth.
Do other people know this?
Don't nobody know, so I'm gonna drop it. I want everybody to know this piece of information.
My thing is, I can't tell Lauryn what to do. I can try to advise this bitch. Bitch, it's not a good idea. Just leave it alone. But Lauryn has her reasons for wanting to go at Kendra because Kendra been coming at her. She been posting shit. She been writing songs about it. She been doing all this stuff. It's just like, Lauryn, why you gotta fuck at the party and bring this out at the all-white party? Why? Why can't we just go to the party, drink the people alcohol, eat their food, and take our black ass home, and then you and Kendra can get together, and then you can whip that bam on her forehead. Bam, bitch. I know, bam. Do that, but not at the party.
I'm gonna play it real cool. If she don't get nasty with me, I may let her slide. When she start pick with me, I'm gonna need you to say Kendra, leave Lauryn alone. I'm just letting you know.
All right. Well, you know this all white party is gonna turn into a bloodbath.
That's why I'm not wearing all white, I'm wearing black.
Bye, Lauryn. Bye. Girl, no, she ain't gonna have me fucked up.
Good.
So I done ran my ass all the way back to the office, honey. I had a lot of interviews to do, and my phone start ringing. I look down, goddamn, it's Coco, honey. Most people know Coco from SWB, but I happen to know her as a friend, as a mentor, as a good sister. And I'm so glad she's calling, because, child, we got so much stuff to catch up on.
So I text you earlier, and thank you for calling. So I wouldn't say I've necessarily been stressed out, but everyone knows me from like radio and the red carpet and things of that nature. And I took a long break, almost a 3-4 year break, and just trying to get back into it now, being in Atlanta, being in a new city. I'm just trying to figure out how can Travis just jump back into it now, because there's a lot of little piglets and little turds and tides and ants and roaches running around here with a microphone, and they don't know what they're doing, you know? So I'm just trying to figure out, you know, I don't know what to do.
Well, since you know what to do, since you know how to do it, you have to just jump back in there and do it the way that you do it. You can't worry about all the piglets and the turds and all of them. You can't worry about them, because if you worry about them, then
you're gonna stunt your growth, right? Mm-hmm. So you just gotta do you and show them how it's done.
Right, and I feel like since you've been in industry for...
Child, since I was in my Pampers for all that long. You know, and I feel that you took like a small break, but you was able to just kind of jump back into it. Like, what kind of motivated you to just, you know, say, hey, I'm not going to care what people say. I'm just going to do it my way type of feel.
Because, you know, that's just how I am. I don't care what people say. And, you know,
when you do things the right way and you leave and you come back, people appreciate that. You know what I'm saying?
So I've been out of radio for 3-4 years now, and just trying to get back in the hang and swing of things. It's been very, very challenging for me because it's a lot of new faces, and I've done this a long time ago, so trying to jump in with new faces and trying to catch a new trend, I don't know what the hell to do. And that's one thing I like about Coco. Every time we do talk, she always gives me the best advice. So this advice, I need to hear this.
You can't worry about what everybody else is saying.
I know, and speaking of everyone saying, so you know, in this new little group, around these new people.
Yes. How is that?
It's different, I would say that. I think this group, it's a lot of potential in the group, it's a lot of entrepreneurs, so.
I like surrounding myself around these people, but.
It's a few screws that are kind of loose, and I'm trying to tighten up. You know, I'm the type of person, I want everybody to get along.
Right.
I feel like we can all make money together, we can all do things together, but when y'all throwing chairs and glasses and with the fists and stuff, I'm like.
Yeah. Yeah, that kind of just, you know, messes things up, but you know.
I'm behaving, and so this is what I decided to do. So I'm actually going to do an all-white right party. So you know how the people and the girls and the guys and the boys and all the other ones, they want to, you know, try to read everybody and try to do all these things. Because I feel like I don't really know nobody in the group like that. And I want to get an opportunity to kind of know them. And being thrown into this after the Christmas party, after there was a fight there, and then after Troy's birthday party, it was a fight there. I feel like the group really don't know each other. I'm going to bring a tarot card reader to read everybody.
Oh, Lord.
What do you think about that?
I don't know. Did you know? If the tarot card reader said the wrong thing, I don't know.
Well, you know, they read for blood and for truth, you know, so.
A lot of the people that the groups read, so kind of off a little bit.
So we need to bring somebody that's outside the group, come into the group, and just read everybody. Hell, you can read me a little bit. Don't read me too much, but, you know, I just want to see what it's going to be about.
As long as it's done in a good way.
Like, whoever the person is being
respectful.
Mm-hmm.
I know for me, you're not just gonna come and read me and tell me something that I don't even know you.
I don't know if I'm gonna be able to handle it.
Okay.
I may have to read you back.
So in this moment, Coco, she's really giving me some good advice. I'm not the best planner. I'm used to being just the person that actually shows up and just do my job, but actually planning the actual event. She's giving some good damn advice right now. Thank you, Coco.
I think by now they should know my heart.
Well, I think if anybody can do this, you can do it.
Thank you, Coco. Now, I know I gotta run real quick, but you know, so I'm bringing back season 3 of Real Talk with Travis Ware. And I know I tried to get you last season, you know, kind of had little technical things going on. But I would love for you to be a guest.
Yeah, we're going to make this happen. Yeah, we're going to make it happen for real.
Definitely make this happen. Let's go to Popeye's, honey. We need to go to Popeye's, get us some chicken and, you know, have some fun. And, you know, I'll let you know how this little party turns out.
Please. All right.
All right. Take care. Bye.
Taste testing a couple months ago, but he actually has his lunch happening today. So I pull up to the scene with my boy Riko. I'm not sure where the fuck Travis came from, but we're finna get in here, eat some good food, and have a good time.
She coming in here with a whole damn outfit on.
How you doing?
Today, I have been invited to Mr. Oliver Twist's seasoning launch, and I am excited to be here just for somebody in our community to be branching out and doing something different. And also, I haven't seen the guys in a very long time, so I'm ready to, you know, vibe out.
So today is a soft launch of my seasoning, Twixt Fix, presented by Poker Couture, Maui Integration, and Pretty Business in collaboration with Phenomenal Food Catering. Chef Holly, who is the CEO and the chef of Phenomenal Food, has worked diligently in perfecting this recipe. Now, of course, I created the cartoon, the packaging, and all of the overall marketing material for this. Oliver Twixt, a gay young black boy, has built a platform for himself strong enough to launch a seasoning that he is the face of. And it just feels very good to have, it's just a reminder, like, bitch, you doing it.
So was the food good?
It was, the shrimp was actually really bomb. The shrimp was bad. It was just like they peeled
shrimp,
it off.
Yeah, the shrimp was real good.
It was really good.
They peeled it this time.
They peeled it this time, so I was
what happened last time?
Riko was eating the fucking peel on the shrimp. He was eating the skin.
Now everything looks great. You know, we're having a great time, all of that jazz. But we came here for the food. And I know y'all think that I'm about to read the food, which I'm not gonna do that. Yes, I am. First off, it was a little cold, I'm not even gonna lie. The shrimp was actually peeled, y'all. Funniness and everything aside, everything tasted really amazing. Oliver always delivers when it comes to food. He knows how to cook, okay? That's one thing that no one can take from Mr. Oliver Twist.
At the end of the day, like I said, I'm just happy
you
that-
you know something?
What?
Before you get to that, her good girlfriend wasn't here.
Who?
My good girlfriend.
Talk about Troy?
No.
Well, Troy's in Denver. Troy?
We're talking about
Lauryn. I was being funny with that. But, I don't know her.
Girl.
I really don't know her. I don't know her. I've never met her.
It would have been nice for her to come out and support her girl, but...
I think it probably might have been retaliation that nobody showed up to her.
Her birthday?
Y'all didn't go
to her birthday. Girl, it was a fucking tornado on her
outside.
Birthday.
It was like a hurricane outside. And then no, she texted me at like 1 o'clock in the morning and was like, hey, sis, you coming? I'm like... I was pretending like I was asleep, but I was
not pretending. Oh my God.
Well, girl.
We're sitting here after everybody has eaten their plates, and they bring up the fact that Lauryn is not here. I'm not surprised, but they're surprised. These girls not real friends out here in these streets, because if this was your real friend, she'll be here supporting you. You're in the city, but you're not here. That's questionable.
Well, what the hell y'all out here? That's why I can't find
myself. We thought you were still in that.
You munching, baby. Right. I was munching, but the biscuit got caught up right here. I was like, wait a minute, water!
But did you enjoy the food?
Yeah. I did. I actually did.
Okay.
The shrimp was really, really good. The season was good on there. I could put in my man butt crack and lick it right up.
What? Okay. The butt crack?
What y'all think of the food?
Okay.
You well, you know, I didn't eat because I'm allergic to shellfish, and I feel like... Well, the seasoning is on the shrimp, girl.
I put that damn seasoning on my grits and eggs.
Okay.
Mix it together.
The bacon. No, ma'am. You still doing your event or whatever?
I am. I'm so excited about it. It's going to be really, really fun. The food's going to be hot. It's going to be very nice. No alcohol.
No alcohol. No,
what you mean the food going to be hot? Like, what is going on?
He know the food was cold. He can agree with me. We were sitting at the table talking about it.
So, I may be eating a lot, but one thing I do, I pay attention to everything that's going around. And every time this group gets together, it's always alcohol involved. Y'all ain't getting no damn alcohol on me. You better drink before you get here. I'm barely gonna have water. And you better hope that refrigerator work got some ice cubes that gonna come out. I ain't bringing no bags of ice. We ain't gonna have no alcohol. We may have some food. It's gonna be hot and ready. And that's it.
What type of entertainment you gonna have? If you ain't gonna have no liquor, like what you got playing?
I mean, well, everybody always trying to read everybody. So I'm gonna have somebody there that's gonna read us.
That's gonna who?
Read us.
Oh, I don't
like that.
I don't like no strangers trying to read me, child.
I do. I'm pulling
it
up.
It's always good, you know, because a lot of people reads me off, you know, so.
So Travis tells us more about the all-white party that, you know, he's gonna have food. He said no liquor. But girl, I'm still bringing some wine or something. Like, bitch, I'm not gonna be at a party with these hoes and not drink nothing. They be stressing me the fuck out. But I hope the food, you know, It's hot. I hope it ain't cold. Says take a page from Oliver's book, baby. Make sure the food is warm.
I really want everybody to have a good time here. I want people to really get to know each other.
Please. And, you know, I feel like I don't know none of these.
Right. So I think this will be a good time for us to get to know each other, understand our backstories, and then, you know, hopefully bond a little bit.
Okay.
I ain't trying to fix somebody's life or anything. Okay. But, you know.
Your shit.
And the bad talk.
Okay, bitch.
So are you inviting everybody?
I'm inviting everybody but Wayne.
Okay.
So I heard you had something to say this to the kids.
What was you at my birthday? Everybody was there, or people that couldn't make it, they was there. I sent an invitation out to everybody.
Oh, Riko, not the bag.
Hold on. Wait a minute.
All I'm saying is you got something, you can hit the kid up.
But I did hit you up, but you didn't respond. You left me on the scene.
Oliver is making an announcement on the inside, so we got to get on the inside.
Well, come on, let's go.
We have no vanilla cake.
It's hot.
Well, first of all, I want to thank everybody in this room for coming out today and supporting me in this new venture that Chef Holly has me on. Before I close out and let you guys go, first, the seasoning is available on my website. Today, I didn't want to, you know, deal with money and stuff like that. So you can go on my website, www.OliverTwixt, that's with an XT.com, and you can go to the Twixt Fix seasoning tab and you can order it, show me it today, and I'll let you walk away with it. This moment is so magical to me right now. I'm just seeing everyone's face in here, and there's no way that a little nerdy boy from Fort Lauderdale, you know, who never thought he would fit in and was afraid to, like, you know, just be himself and try to, you know, y'all know the game. We know the game. We know the game.
It's just the beginning.
Yeah.
I tell, you know, Paris Bennett in the room, I tell her all the time, you know, it's so amazing what God has done in my life and the people he's placed in my life and how things have gone from one thing to another to another. I'm going on 2 years right now, haven't clocked in, worked in for nobody. And I don't take that for granted. It's a blessing that I can wake up every day and do what I love, be recognized for what I love, and be surrounded by people who just love me like,
you know, no matter what went right in this event, this soft launch, what went right, what went wrong, the fact that my grandparents, who used to pick cotton and cleaned up white people's homes, and my mother, who had a very tumultuous upbringing and some traumatic things happened to her in her childhood, the fact that they are alive and breathing and watching, it's a moment that I wish I really honestly can bottle up. Like, the look in my granddaddy's eyes, he was so proud. And in everything I do, I want to make my grandparents proud. I want to make my mom proud. I want to make people like Contessa, who've poured in my life, everybody that's ever spent a dime, nickel invested in me, I want to make them proud. And I want to build a legacy that my children and my family, the people that have to come after me, they will be proud too. And I think this is a very, very nice start.
I don't know what God is doing in this little black boy's life, but he's doing something. And I'm just letting you guys know that I'm taking everything that's being given to me, every platform, every venture, every opportunity, I'm taking it serious, because every day I'm looking at y'all in my brain. I'm looking like, I don't want to let them down. I don't want to disappoint them. I want to make sure that the plan and the vision that God has imparted in all of y'all to give me the love that y'all have given me comes to fruition. Twixt Fix Seasoning. Let's make it.
I don't want no bottles when I leave. Take all the bottles with you. So when you buy it, just show me the receipt, and it is yours.
Coming up on Chasing Atlanta.
Oliver, you ready to go motherfucking party, bitch?
First of all, I really want to just reach out to you and have a conversation with you, because
we're gonna just go on straight into the fight.
Girl, we better move forward. Like, I don't got no problem with nobody. Let's keep it cute.
First of all, you are her help, and that's why people feel some type of way about you.
It ain't even about picking a side or none of that, Oliver. You gonna have to just be you.
You have to
scale, bitches. I don't.
Where my bag at?
ZAP, zapping all you hoes away like, get back. ZAP, zapping all you hoes away like.
My name is Imani Van Zapp, and I am here to help you fix your shit. Listen, this episode here, I'm shocked. Y'all, okay, let's get into it. The petty moment for me was Troy. Troy, let me tell you something. You came so close to going into the bottom. By the way that you did that phone call with Kendra. How you gonna record your shade and send it to her? Baby, you gotta go to work. If you don't have time to meet with her, you do not have time to sit in front of a full background and record a video. I'm the only one on this show that has a fabulous background and sends assessments. Trying to act like you me. Now I'm gonna give you props because I believe it was your attempt to try to start a conversation with her, but baby, I gotta let you know, that was passive aggressive. Because of the dynamic that you have as cast members, recording a video and sending it does not give the other person a chance to respond. Now there's just more irritation and questions. Next time, let's just have the conversation in person or just not at all. Since we'll be at the reunion, you'll get your chance. Now I'm telling y'all, this episode was something else. The powerful moment was actually a tie. The first pair was Oliver and Q. Now, while I still have some questions, and we will ask those at the reunion, I do have to give an A for effort, that the both of you sat down and made an attempt to hash out your issues, okay? Travis, thank you for being a mediator. Once you both settled down and stopped all the screaming and slamming on tables, you can actually hear one another. That's what this is all about. The second powerful moment for me was between Riko with a K and Cameron. I just love this conversation, how heartfelt it was and vulnerable, and to show support between two young men. We need more of that. I'm trying to get all y'all to understand that y'all need one another. Baby, the strongest moment for this week had a four-way tie. I don't know how y'all pulled that off. Troy, Kendra, Lauryn, and Oliver. Like I've said before, the show is called Chasing Atlanta. All I want to see is you going after your dreams. For good measure, I'm going to go ahead and throw Dominique in there as an honorable mention. He was the one that showed up and supported. This is what it is all about, which takes me to the weakest of the week. No one. This is the first time in Chasing Reality history that we didn't have this. We need to celebrate. Break out the champagne. No, wait, don't break out liquor because some people don't know how to act. Babies, I mean this with my whole heart. I take this work seriously. Yes, there's a little bit of shade. Yes, there's a little bit of tension. We're going to settle those things. I have to stop and say, this is the most loving episode that you have had all season. Contrary to popular belief, reality TV should not be all about fights. As you go forward in your paths, you need to be careful about the moves that you make. Watch how you treat each other and watch how you treat yourself. It all matters. Remain stronger and better. I am so proud of you all, I don't know what to do. Everyone show some love in the comments on below and tell us who is your favorite cast member and why. Once again, this is Imani Van Zapp. And I'll see you soon. Bye, babies.
Cassandra James is smart, sexy, and single.
Ron?
Damn, you even sexier than I remember.
Rekindling a spicy relationship from her past is only the beginning of a dangerous downward spiral.
We can't do this, Ty. You're my best friend's man.
You used to be the love of my life.
I can't do this anymore. You married Ron.
I see how my man looks at you.
But now?
I'm pregnant, and I'm not keeping it.
Do not kill my baby.
Please don't do this.
Sediction. A novel by G. Nez.
I am excited, but life happened. My outfit is not here. The food is not here. My car broke down, the brakes went out. I didn't have time to do decorations. I didn't have time to do anything as planned. And I'm a little aggravated, so I'm trying to get back in good spirits because I want to make sure that I'm bringing positive energy to everybody. I made sure to not have alcohol. A little wine is okay, no alcohol. And this time, you know, so I ain't got to worry about breaking up fights, so nobody can break up fights. I got a security guard, so hopefully come here and rescue the day and be Hercules and all that stuff. So we're going to see how it goes. I'm aggravated, but I'm here.
Girl, what the fuck we at? What
is going on? Watch out.
Not
gonna hit the damn phone, please.
Girl, you ghetto.
Who is it?
Hello.
It's me, ho. This,
ooh, child, I got strippers.
Hold on, baby.
It's a
man. Oh, I didn't know what type of stripper that man.
Pull up, friend up, bad bitches. Me and Nick done pulled up to the party with my boy Riko, and you already know how it's gonna go. Listen, we came to shut the scene down, and we're gonna do what we gotta do. We know everybody gonna be here tonight. I ain't come here to fight. I ain't come here to do all that. I just really came to get all the issues out on the table and leave in peace.
Wait, hold up. Is it me, or do you not see that this is the same exact shirt that Travis had on at Troy's birthday brunch? Bitch, you said this was an all-white party, and that is not all-white. You could have called me, girl. My boyfriend was extra large too. Maybe a 2X. We could have found something for you to fit.
What is giving tonight?
It's gonna give realness.
The hoes have a hard time with that.
And well, you know, with all the, I'm pretty sure you've seen all everything that's been going on.
I have. I was trying to stay away from it, but I really want everybody to come.
You trying to stay away from
it. I heard you with some shit, yo,
man. Okay, because you was on your story talking about somebody with a shrimp.
Oh, and somebody suck at shrimp wee-wees.
Who you talking about,
shrimp? Because I know my man ain't got no shrimp dick, and I'm allergic to shellfish, so I'm confused.
Well, it's not either.
Okay. A couple weeks ago, Travis went on this crazy rant on his Instagram about how about somebody man got this shrimp dick and all this crazy stuff. So when I saw him, I thought that we should talk about it before everybody gets here. I do not want to make a big scene. Everybody say I'm messy. So I was hoping we could talk about it before the group gets here. But the bitch is backpedaling and pussy popping. I know she just might be talking about me. She says she not, but we gonna find out tonight.
So you this, to come is my together? Goal. This is my goal. I want everybody to come together. Mm-hmm. I feel like the group is gonna know each other. So I want everybody to go around and kind of like tell themselves about each other.
These hoes gonna be burning in their skin.
Can I ask you a question? Does that mean you're not feeling
I'm here.
Are you?
With everybody.
I am. Not nice.
Well, we gonna find out.
Now, let me be real with y'all. I'm mad. Because at Troy's little birthday party, I spent $30 for some food. I ain't even eat then. So then Travis talking about, I'm having a whole white party and we're gonna have food and we have this, we're gonna have this and that. And I walk in, there ain't no damn food. And I hate to, you know, sit here and read people's events and things of that nature because that's not what I'm about. However, I came here with an empty stomach. Baby boy, the food. Wine, something. Can I get a drink? Water, something. No.
I want to know who's sucking on some shrimp penis.
Girl, you know this is
Travis. No, that's kind of my feel because I want to get a little tea. So who may got a shrimp dick?
Hope this gonna be a productive day. I ain't got time for no bullshit. Open up the door.
What's up?
So I walk into the all-white party event that Travis has thrown. I don't see no food. I don't see any liquor. I mean, he asked me to bring some chips to dip, but I thought it was the add-on to the food he already had. So for a person that likes to eat so much, where's the food, Travis?
Oh, you gonna lick his toes?
I'm not gonna lick his toes.
Come on, Riko, do one more time. Riko, with a K.
Oh, K, you
gotta put
the arch in the foot for me.
Let me see.
Mama
let
got
see.
A nasty arch in her foot.
Ooh. Ooh.
Oh, come on, Riko, kiss it.
Oh, lick that toe.
The bit all your mouth.
All right, y'all, let's go.
So tonight is the first time that the group and the world gets to see the power of three reunited, and I know that people are shocked. So we are looking good and feeling good, and tonight we plan on getting down to the bottom of the mess that's just been happening in the group, and I know that they are shocked boots that we all three are back in just one area, one time, and just keep these girls in charge and let them know what's really going on. The big three did not come to play today.
Let's party.
We're gonna party because they're trying to give us no direction of where we're going.
The big three.
We had a good time
in a long time.
And so we don't have fun tonight. The night is young, we in ATL, and the power of three is back. So let me tell y'all, you know me and Q been gone. The power three have not been together. So this is the first time tonight that everybody even know that the power of three is back together. So let's go up there, let's go get some food, and let's just have some fun with the girls tonight. And let's see what it's giving. Let's see if they really gonna be quiet.
Oh my God. Bitch, somebody done paid the motherfucking power bill in this bitch. The power of three showed up together. Girl, last time I heard, these bitches was beefing. But you know what? Progress is great in the community. I'm happy to see them together. So girl, let's just have a good old Ponderosa.
Now when I walked into the facility, if my memory serves me right, didn't Miss Travis say she's used to the grand and the fabulous and the drinks and the alcohol? This bitch got motherfucking nachos and dip. And it ain't even cheese dip. Was it cheese dip? I don't remember cheese. I just saw salsa and chips with the scoops. And I mean, at least she put the scoops. The scoops. But it was like, girl, we could have all got on a Zoom call for this. You done got all of us gussied up thinking we finna come to an all-white party at this air. And then it's like, girl, haven't we seen this Airbnb info? This is the Airbnb. This ain't your house. This is it. I try not to shade the girls too much, but it's just like, girl, what is this? I could have stayed home and scratched my nuts.
They don't
own
her.
I'm waiting to take this.
Oh my goodness, as y'all see, the queen has arrived. And you know, I saw Q on Instagram earlier. I think his mega bus made it. I just walked past Lauryn England's rental car, so she's here. Ooh, Lord, let's see what this is gonna be. Now, Lord, I come to you in the name of Jesus. Let me let these people know how I feel, Lord, without reaching out and touching. Jesus' name, amen.
80 Productions.
I know y'all are surprised to see me in a room with the big three. It's been a whole lot of talking, and today we're gonna get down to some answers. Hey y'all,
come talk. Let the situation go and see how this come
on. Walk with me.
See how life can fake
out. Kendra, you got your word, okay?
Everybody's
here.
I know. Well, I just want to make sure everybody's energy good. Everybody's in the best behavior.
Okay.
It's the first time everybody's been around.
Yeah, and I hate that it had to be like this. But I mean, I'm cool.
I mean, as long as everybody's everybody stay on their little, you know.
And the reason I didn't want you to come, and the reason why, it was because I didn't have an issue with you or anything. But I just didn't want everything that went down the same way to happen. But I'm glad you're here anyways, because you deserve to be here. And that's real shit. Like, for real, for real. You deserve to be here. You deserve to have people understand you more. And if I really want to bring this group together, you have to be here. So, thank you.
We're here to make a statement. I mean, as long as they stay normal and keep people, you know what I'm saying? Keep the people. This will be
the only person I want to talk to today anyway, is Troy. So.
That's a dope. I appreciate that.
Yeah. I mean, all that little shade shit, we don't give a damn about that.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Well, I'm glad. And I know y'all able to talk our stuff, but we was able to hash out a little whatever we had going on. Then I know y'all don't know what to say, so.
Okay.
So, you know, I'm briefing them on everything. I apologize to Wayne. Originally, I didn't want Wayne to come because I want people to see Kendra outside of Wayne. And I just feel as though that sometimes Wayne is there and Kendra's there and just makes a commotion with the whole group. But I had to apologize to him because he deserves to be here in this moment. Everybody needs to be here in this particular moment. I'm a little bit on edge, but I'm really, really hoping because she promised me that she would be on her best behavior, at least try to be on her best behavior. So we'll see. I got my eye on you.
So since we are in a good moment right now, me and Lauren are, you know, clearly talking to each other, I just feel like I'm in the mood to reconcile and to end and mend some broken fences. So why not just go ahead and pull Kendra to the side, have our conversation, and see where it goes from here.
First of all, I really want to reach out to you and have a conversation with you simply because of what happened at the, you know, at my event, at my birthday brunch. And I really been having like a lot of emotion towards it, and I know you guys, we're supposed to meet up, and I couldn't come for certain reasons, and I wanted to have a conversation with you by myself to talk to you because I genuinely felt like we had a friendship.
We did.
I hate how that situation happened. It happened, and I will explain to you why I reacted the way I did, because simply, I feel like as a friend, and coming to something that you knew, like me being a friend and something that you knew that was for me, and my birthday, and I talked about my birthday and it being my birthday, I really didn't want any of that going down. So for being my friend, you should have at least be able to respect, because it was really, honestly, it was no shame. Like, we really were trying to keep everything calm so that we could really get, because we had a lot planned. We really had a lot planned. We had really sat down and went through that day to have a lot planned. Like, it was supposed to be fun.
We're going to just go on straight into the fight. See, when I came back out down, came back out the bathroom or whatever from getting upset or whatever, I was calm. You get what I'm saying? I wasn't trying to do nothing extra or anything. I was calm. When Oliver looked at me and said, "You ugly bitch," or whatever, yeah, that hit a button right there. It's everything started up. And I didn't see what Wayne saw, which was you threw something at me.
Yeah, I threw a cup. Why? My thing at that moment, I feel like there was no way
I'm
else.
I'm your friend. Did I ever make you feel like you had to choose between me and Oliver?
Like, you never made me feel like
that. Because if I did, no, I might have told you to watch out, watch your back, did. But I'm sure everybody don't feel
that. It was never that. It was the fact that in that moment, for my event, I was trying to make sure that everything was okay. I wanted everything to be okay. So at that moment, after trying to keep everything down and keep going, and after I had done rage, I grabbed you and tried to take you out.
I didn't know what was going on. Like, I was wondering, it shocked me. I was shocked and I was hurt. When I looked over there and saw that it was y'all, I'm like, hold on, wait a minute. The people that's even supposed to be here ain't even here. What the fuck is going on? When it was brought to my attention that you throw something at me, I said, what? I didn't see that. But he did.
But
and that being my friend, Wayne is my manager, my best friend, everything. He reacted on that.
And see.
And things.
And I understand that, but let me tell you something.
Just how your friend came out
the
kitchen.
And that's what, right.
Now, Troy is here, and I'm listening to him. He's talking, and I just want to just reach out and slap the shit out of him. Because I told you, Troy. I told your ass. And now, here you are. You gotta face me. But Troy, I really was your friend, and I really thought you was my friend. That's what hurted me the most. Like, but, you know, I told you so. How are you all over now? Yes, did he show you?
It wasn't about him.
We gotta forgive. And I forgive you, Troy. I believe in second chances.
Yes.
You know, that's what I want to give people. A second chance to get right and notice me. You get what I'm saying? Because I come with a lot of anger, emotions, and everything. And sometimes when I can't get it out.
And I feel that. And let me tell you something. As a friend, me being a friend to you, you don't have to get mad. You can talk about it. Because guess what? That's what I'm here for. You can talk to me. That's the kind of person I am. You can talk to me. You don't have to get up. If you, even at the brunch, if you got that mad, you could have said, hey, I need to get up and take a minute.
I don't know what triggered everything. It was just a lot. It's a lot. A lot of people in this group hurt me.
So Kendra is telling me how she's hurt and, you know, how she's been hurt by people in the group. And my thing is, as a friend, listen, I'm an empath and I can always read through people. I knew that Kendra was hurt. I know that Kendra's hurt. But my thing is, it's a better way for her to, you know, release her emotions or to speak on how she's feeling other than getting violent, you know? And like I said, in this moment, like, I understand her and I'm with her. And it's that I don't feel any way about Kendra because I still love Kendra. But I want her to understand, like, listen. And as for me too, because I'm going to take my part in saying that I did what I did. But I want her to know, like, listen, you can talk about it. I'm a friend. You can talk to me about it. You can sit here and express your feelings to me and tell me how you feel versus getting mad at everybody else.
Hopefully we'll be able to end those wounds, you know, but I'm hurt.
I know.
And it's like, I didn't mean to have that happen at your party or whatever, but a lot of things happened that I didn't see and it transpired, but I forgive you. I miss you too.
Once again, I'm trying to grow. I'm trying to change things. I got a lot of things coming up and forgiveness is something that I believe in. I just want to let it go and show people that, you know, I can forgive people. I can sit down and talk to people and have a full conversation without hitting people. I can do that. But we have to be on the same page. And Troy, I'm just letting it go, boo. Don't do that shit no motherfucking more, though.
Tonight, you're the only person. Because I felt something there. One thing that I do know is when it's genuine, it's genuine.
Yes.
If I'm going to really make up with somebody tonight, it was you. Right. I can leave now. See, with them, it's like, I saw everything for myself. You know, the problem is, everybody be so quick to put everything on Wayne, the problem. The problem is, people need to own up to what
everybody,
they did.
Everybody,
you get what I'm saying?
Then
that's all I want to hear.
I agree.
You feel me?
Own
up to what you did.
We come and give us a second, please. Thank.
And that's just that.
Yeah.
Own up to that blame game. That's my best friend. That's why we loyal to each other. You know. But at the end of the day, I don't want to hear everything, because that's what's out there. It's all Wayne. No, baby. It's own up to what you did.
Right. Well, let's get it.
I'm trying to end these.
Let's end it.
We can end it or however the hell it
gotta go. Let's go. Get your bag, girl. Chanel me down. Chanel on my fingernails.
You better know it.
You don't know. Now you know.
I hope everybody was able to kind of talk a little bit. I know we can't hash out everything tonight, one-on-one. I hope y'all were able to start the conversation. However, I think now that everybody had the opportunity to kind of talk one-on-one a little bit, I just think the entire group would come together and kind of hash out stuff that needs to be hashed out group-wide.
We want
to
start with you.
Okay.
And a shrimp dish.
This is for me. Y'all know I get along with everybody, right?
Mm-hmm.
I get along with you?
Oh, yeah, me.
I get along with you. You, right? So that we all know that I get along with everybody. What I don't appreciate is when I come around, I try to be positive with everybody. I try to show love to everybody. If I see something that's repostable, then I repost it when I can. Y'all tag me, find out like, y'all make me post and all that stuff. But I feel as though that the respect is not returned when it comes to me. So I'm just gonna say, it's like times where I can really call out almost everybody in the room where I just felt like it's been a level of disrespect. And I'm the type of person, I'm like, okay, let me just brush it off, let me not do anything, let me not say anything. But at the end of the day, I'm going home, I'm like, hold on, wait a minute.
Who
You know, I've been disrespected multiple times, and I never said nothing to anybody, and I just let it brush off. But after a while, when it started getting building and building and building, it just started to the point where, like, damn, like, am I doing something wrong? Like, or anything like that? I feel like everybody had their moment.
Almost everybody.
I feel like this has been
doing
Almost everybody. Not everybody.
What was it for me? That's what I'm trying to say.
It wasn't for you.
So are you going to be feeling an angle?
Yeah. Now this is...
Let's go.
Give me the floor. Now I want everybody to respect my opinion. My thing, just like, if y'all don't agree, then you don't agree. I just feel as though, like, the situation happened between me and you, Dominique, I kept hearing it over and over, even after the fact.
So you talking about my man got a shrimp dick?
No.
Yeah, so I'm allergic to shellfish, baby. My man ain't got no shrimp dick.
It's not about so you and your shrimp dick. No, it wasn't like about you and your shrimp dick.
Like, girl, you pulled me on top of you at the Christmas party, and I thought we moved past that, bro.
We did move past that, which I thought that we moved
so
past it. However,
no.
If I wanted to talk about your man,
he don't collect an employment check.
I never said your man.
My man worked two jobs.
Did I say that your man did that?
Baby.
Did you ask me that I said that I was talking about your man tonight?
You said no, but girl, I'm starting to think.
All right, so if I said no, then it's a no.
Okay, girl. Travis now has the exact audience that he was hoping for. He got Lauryn watching, he got Q watching, he got Miss Oliver watching, and now he backpedaling all over the place. Girl, you full of shit. These girls ask you who the fuck you talk about, and you can't even tell your girls who you talking about. Girl, you fake as fuck, and you wanted a moment, bitch, you got gutted, fished, and bitch shipped out. At this point, you're done.
After we squashed it at Troy's birthday, I didn't even know you had an issue about it, or I forgot about it. I just kept hearing it over and over and over.
You heard about it past Troy's birthday, baby. You pulled me on top of you, and we moved past it. I thought it was disrespectful because of the fact that this is our first time meeting, and that's not the way you introduce yourself to nobody. That's just it. Mm-hmm. And I've seen you do it on other platforms. Right. So if you talk about me, once again, I thought it was disrespectful, and my man do not have a shrimp dick.
I never said your man had a shrimp dick.
He got a cold sauce.
Bitch, I'm not even talking about you. Why are you trying to have another moment? I thought we was good. I just asked you, not even 13 minutes ago, if we were good or not, and you said yes. So why did you think that I have the time or the audacity to say I'm good with somebody to turn around and try to say that your man got a shrimp dick and he working on unemployment check? If he got a shrimp dick, that's none of my damn business. If he got an unemployment check, that ain't none of my damn business. The bitch got money at the end of the day. But I'm not talking about you, Dominique. Shut up. You are even with the wind at this moment. Go on with the wind. Go over there. Don't be trying to have a moment with me because you ain't going to work out.
I'm just making it very clear that I've tried to build a relationship with everybody in this room. Friendship, relationship. Anything, like business transactions, anything. Like, girl, don't do that. Like I said, we can move on because I don't want to get worked up. Everybody got to talk. But when it comes to us, we good. Like I said, I did speak on it multiple times until me and you talked on it. Like, we hadn't talked on it until we sat down at Troy's birthday brunch. And that, even then, I went on the rah-rah shit. I don't come on that rah-rah shit.
I have two questions. Are you going to say, if you weren't speaking about his boyfriend in this group,
I never talked about his boyfriend.
Hold on, let me finish. If you're saying it wasn't his boyfriend you were referring to in this group, who was? And then who were also the people that were telling you that he was still talking about it, just so we can resolve it?
His bird is going to be all right. That's all I'm saying.
The who?
That's his bird.
You take us out. Let's move on.
Let's move on. Like I said, I have no issue with anybody. Me and Lauryn talked about our issues. We've worked past it. Like I said, we had issues when it came to my little sister. Like I said, we don't have those issues today because, like I said, when I talk about something, I'm moving past it. Me and Lauryn has talked about it. Like I said, she presented my little sister with an opportunity. It went left. Shit went left. I wanted to talk to her about it. She granted me that conversation. I respect you for that. We're gonna move past that shit. Anything in the future, that's what I'm gonna hold her accountable for. Like I said, any slick comments, I'm done with it. If she done with it, but I match energy. I felt like she was coming at me some type of way, so I responded. I would hope that from today, anybody can take this as an example. Move the fuck forward if you talked about it. Me and Lauryn talked about it, we moving forward. That's all I got to say.
That's real. That's very adult.
Cheers to that.
For real.
Yeah.
Time
for the bullshit.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
I will.
Okay,
Troy.
I will.
So, friend, you're my friend. With me and you, it's not really no issue. But of course the day, and we spoke about this before, this is something that's still been on me because I feel like it's been brought up several times every time I'm around, people bringing up, you know, the situation that happened at my brunch. And I understand you as a person. I know you have a platform, whatever case may have you. But in that instance, it really technically wasn't my battle. And after being there and seeing that how everything happened and not being my battle, it kind of really hurt my feelings that you had nothing to do with it. And then after the fact, you pretty much just like, you didn't show any support to me. I feel like you didn't throw a drink back, you didn't throw a chair back, you didn't do anything. And it just made me feel like in that moment, if my friend had not been there cooking for us, like, no shade, because I'm not saying the bitches were in a bad way, but these bitches could have jumped me, literally. Could have whooped my ass for filming. And not saying that any of them would let it happen, but we weren't even that cool at that moment. If I'm your friend, if that was Dominique, and just how Travis is coming at Dominique for no reason right now, in this moment, I'm gonna speak up for my friend. When it's you come, when they were coming for you in that moment, and I knew that we were trying to get somewhere, I spoke up for my friend. But I feel like my friend did not speak up for me in that moment, and that hurt my feelings.
I see that. My apologies. I don't want you to think I wasn't, like, with you in that moment. Everything just happened kind of so quickly. And so I just didn't, it was a lot of motion going on. And me personally, you already know how I feel about that type of stuff. Like that's,
I know.
That's not how I was raised. Or, you know, like, that's not the type of life I know. I don't mind doing it if I have to. But in that moment, it was just a lot going on. And maybe I didn't act the best way that I could have. Next, only thing I saw was everybody was just innocent fighting. Sorry. I understand. I understand what you're saying. I'm receiving, and I do view you as a friend. So I don't want you to think that I just left you out there. But I do receive what you said.
I appreciate it. Mm-hmm.
It's an adult-ish for me. I love this.
Now, Troy, it seemed like you trying to do this to all of her, honey, like you just did me. Now I'm confused. Whose side is you on, baby? Is it just yours? Or was you really trying to make us work? Or, you know, all of this shit is just blowing me. But I feel you, dumb. Told you so, too.
Well, no, I'd like to speak. I have a problem. I had a problem. Oh, well, hold on, wait, I went too quick. Go ahead, boo.
I'm done.
You sure?
Yeah.
Well, I had a problem with the power of three. I felt like, and yes, I'm just going to go on and get this over with the best way that I can. I know I put out a lot of music and things to get y'all attention, to let y'all know that I am hurt and I did not appreciate what happened and what took place. When I saw everything that I saw, I just felt disrespected to the utmost. My family went through a lot. My grandmother moved out the house that she was staying in to get me a lawyer. I didn't need money for bond. I had to get a lawyer because I was a flight risk coming from there, from Virginia. My family got together. They sacrificed everything for me. And for me to get up there and hear all of that and just everything, not as much from you, Lauryn, but I knew that you heard the recording from when I called you from jail.
Because I'm not your friend and I'm not telling you nothing to help you. Take me off the song and everybody's going to worry about coming out next week.
So I knew when they did it or whatever, I was just paying attention to everything. I watched that video 29 times. And it's just like, Oliver, like, I see the good in you. I saw it. I saw the genuine person. Sometimes I miss my friend. But I can't be 100% friend to you and you give me 50. What was going on with me was real. I was in a real fucking situation. Racist cops. They were finna kill me and my boyfriend. All we did was drove by them. This is serious. And I just feel like y'all took a serious situation and turned it into a joke.
So if you want to be treated like family, I feel like you should give the respect to family. When have you ever pulled me aside and said, hey, cute, this, that, and the third?
Yeah,
I let you speak. Unsure where you and I went wrong?
I'm very confused where you and I went wrong, because you said you dealt with police brutality and things of such, and I have as well. I have dealt with some of the same things. I have dealt with some of the same things just in this year during the pandemic. So I've never positioned myself to say, oh, you can't come to me or nothing like that. But what I do feel and what I do know is that you have a person who's sitting right here, who is Wayne, that brings you back a lot of false information. I never came to you, so for you to be putting me in songs, that's not paid for. I leave that up to your business manager.
What you mean that's not paid for? That's another thing that y'all do wrong. Don't think that people ain't get money over here, baby. We get money. My music and shit, that's serious to me.
Yeah.
And that music that I put out was to let y'all know that it was a problem, because I've been trying to reach out to y'all.
Hold on. I feel like I need to insert myself in this part right here. And I think it's only fair that I speak. Because at the end of the day, when we first came into this group, I hit Q up. He even posted the message when I asked him that he wanted to film with Kendra so he can get to know her. He didn't acknowledge that. When we was at Henry's, I walked up to him and I tried to talk to him. He didn't acknowledge that. When we was at Oliver's house, I tried to get close to him, but what he did, he pushed me away like I was nobody, which how I feel everybody in this group do, because y'all feel like y'all on some pedestal or y'all somebody. Second, I never did nothing out of the way to Q. I went to you, and I was in an Uber pool, and I was a man enough to sit there, and I said, I apologize. Can I finish? First of all, let me talk. When we was in the Uber pool, I apologized to you for like a man, and I said, let this be over. And you will never hear nothing about me saying anything about you being selfish again, because the comment that you made was selfish.
That's true, and
I said that. But then I go back and I see you posting something online talking about where you will walk down and what you all this you will do and who you don't like. First of all, if you got so much money and you're doing so much, why would you get on your live and worry about me? Second and third of all, Lauryn, I called you. I sat here and talked to Kendra. I told my friend. Give her a second. She don't got to hear it, but because I told Kendra, I said, give her a second chance, because she haven't even really did nothing. Besides, when she called me and disrespect me at 3 o'clock in the morning. First of all, you are for her help. That's why people feel some type of way about you, boo. Come down to your level.
I told Kendra to be your friend and let it go,
because it's not worth it. Baby, at the end of the day, I don't matter. I don't matter. And that's how you made me feel from then until now. So it is what it is. God bless you, and I hope you have a Merry Christmas. And to Oliver, I still don't have a problem with you. If I see you in the street right now, I'm still gonna speak to you. I don't have no problem with you, because you are who you are. But at the end of the day, I don't know what it is about you and Kendra. Y'all need to sit down and resolve it.
Lauryn, my problem with you is I had a genuine conversation with you, girl. It's my first time seeing you. This is my first time being around you. I'm real. Let me tell you, I'm not no fake bitch. I don't do none of that. And when I called you, I wasn't on no fake shit, girl. I was trying to end this shit because I knew you was a girl like me. You took that recording and you passed it down. That showed me right there you wasn't genuine. I didn't record you. I didn't do none of that. Why would you do that? And I'm talking to you, girl.
Let me ask you this, and out of respect for everybody in this room, the only reason I'm angry with you, and the only reason why I did the recording, and I can be honest about what I did.
That's fine.
I ain't gotta lie. I ain't gotta say I did it, because I did. You and I I felt like, and they can bring it back. When we was in Miami, what we did, connected, right?
Yeah,
we was on the beach, we didn't have no issue.
It was good.
I thought, I can't remember, I ain't trying to lie, but I thought you came to a hotel room if you didn't. We got past that. Mm-hmm. We did the song, it was no issue. Now, granted, I can't take this back. I can be honest. I can be a grown woman. I can be an adult. I can be a big foot. I'm just being honest. Cause I got a big nose and big, and I'm getting all
that. And my nose big too.
Trust me, both our nose big, period. But listen, it ain't even about nose. Cause I'm getting my piece in a few weeks.
Yeah, and my surgery's gonna start soon.
You
mm-hmm.
took upon yourself
mm-hmm.
to have an issue with me after you got out of jail, hallway. You did an interview with me about me.
Hell yeah, you called me a clout chaser.
Wait,
the fuck you mean?
Wait,
y'all dissing my brand and everything.
No,
I don't roll like
wait,
that.
I don't roll like that. If I'm gonna own up to my mistakes,
uh-huh.
what I said, let me do that. Yes, I was drunk. I was having a little drink.
Oh, Lord.
And when my good friend here said, did you see the song come out? I said, the song didn't come out. I said, the song came out. I said, I did not know. I did call you Wayne. And I did say clout chaser. I did say, what?
You full of shit.
Q, come on, gang.
He's disrespectful to her.
I see you transitioning because I know what I am. I'm trying to get there. That's fine,
my
baby.
My hands here. My
that's
teeth
fine.
Here. My cheese here.
Congratulations.
Who don't like it, I don't give a fuck.
More congratulations.
Kendra is just full of bullshit. One minute you're saying I did not embrace you. The next minute you're telling me, oh, you was the only one that was welcoming into your world and I want to be your part of your world. Then you get on an interview, which I got proof about. You say that you're mad at me because I told you I was going to dog you up and I didn't do what I said I was going to do. Well, bitch, you went to fucking jail. And if you keep calling me motherfucking Jalen one more time, I promise you it's about to be your ass, Kenneth, bitch. So let me just tell you this. You might want to walk the fuck out while you're walking out now because I promise you, if you keep talking shit, I promise you, I'm about to drag you home.
Baby, you lied and told everybody
I'm
that
not.
I had a Range Rover with an Alaska's head. One thing.
That maroon Range Rover was with an Alaska's head.
With an Alaska's head, let me call one person 1 second.
Girl.
I'm
ready to go.
Yes, I rented a house.
Right.
It went for no show.
Yeah,
I ain't ready to buy
yeah.
one.
You but know what the problem is? When I came on this show and you knew I was one of the girls and you was one of the girls then, you didn't uplift me. You talked about my hair and shit, but not one time did you say,
cuz,
hey, let me do your hair. Let me do that. You didn't say none of that.
Hold on, wait, Godmama, let me ask you this. And my Godmama don't, know we do alcohol.
Okay, Lauren, okay.
Where I got my Range Rover from?
Wait, hold on, Kendra.
Kendra, can I talk to you? In Birmingham. The tag said Alabama. So if the girls came home to read and know that it said Alaska,
can you listen to me?
And I said it said Alabama and not Alaska, then that's not my motherfucking problem. What I'm saying is Lauren has not lied. I don't mean, I don't care what I'm bringing up. Because
now, as you can see, the girls are press. They upset. The truth motherfucking hurts. Now, this bitch don't slip and said she did get the contract. She's trying to explain herself. Kendra, you think it's what? But you know, Kendra, get it out. Kendra, what? Your worst motherfucking nightmare. And another thing that I want to explain to you, girl, you just started this full transition or whatever it is that you're doing. I always knew you was going to be one of the girls. because you the one a while back said that you didn't care if you was called a he, a she, or you're never getting titties, you're never doing none of this, and now y'all making it a big issue. It's finally nice to see the bullies get bullied. It don't feel good, do it?
I'm tired of it. You're not gonna make it seem like I'm just dogging you out, I'm just right. You did interviews about me first. You don't wanna hear the truth, but you did interviews about me first. Now you wanna make episode 1, 2, 3, and 4 about me. I'm gonna make the season finale about motherfucking Lauryn England, cause let me tell you something, bitch. I may not do everything motherfucking right. But as a bitch person, I ain't never in my motherfucking life ever stole from no bitch and had mug shots from motherfucking behind.
So she went to jail for?
Say it. Say it. No, I'm not doing this fake shit. Say what she told y'all she went to jail for. Say what she said she went to jail for.
I really don't know.
You don't know. I'm being serious. Because you have dragged me. You have told bitches that I scare bitches. I don't.
Where my bag is?
Bitch, I got your motherfucker. Give me the motherfucker.
Now, what's funny is, as soon as Kendra walk out the door, Ms. Lauryn pull out this manila envelope. Girl, what the fuck is in the envelope? Bitch, you done got motherfucking tipsy and got on 10 as soon as she walked out the door. I'm confused, girl. What's really going on? What's in the envelope, girl? Tell me. I want to know.
Hey, y'all.
Hi, Oliver.
Listen, while I am a full rider for my friends and I understand where their anger is coming from when it comes to the shit that Wayne, the pain, and Kendra have done to them and me, it's like, y'all, this not the time for all that. And to be quite honest, today is the first time in history of me knowing her that I've seen Kendra genuinely enter into a room and not want to turn up and not take the bait to turn up. I just want to make sure I don't leave here without Kendra and I having a conversation. Me and Q was able to dead our situation. I was able just to apologize to Troy. Kendra, let's try to end all of this right now. So girl, I'm finna come talk to you.
Here's the thing for me, Kendra, like, you know, I've gone through a lot of changes and growth since the last time you and I have spoken. Like, you know, I've grown up a lot, I've had different experiences. I've, you know, realized a lot of things about myself that I probably wasn't in the space to realize that, you know, now in hindsight, you know, I can take responsibility for a lot of things and say, you know what, Oliver, maybe you didn't do the best thing that you could have done in that moment, even though
I showed you I was.
Let me tell you something, Kendra. One thing about it, you know, I can take responsibility for like being obnoxious or not being sensitive, but one thing that's not true about me is someone who's malicious or that sets out to hurt anybody. Like on some real shit, like when everything was going on and we didn't know what your status was on the cast, you can ask. I ain't gonna say no names, but you can ask the people. I was like, don't get rid of her, let her come back.
My thing with this, Oliver, is, and I've said it, and I know you saw the interviews and everything, the music is out and everything. I have my own way of delivering messages. Do you get what I'm saying? I feel like if I can't talk to you, I'm gonna put it in the music. But one thing about it, and for sure, I miss you. I don't say it, you know, because I saw the real you. When we was at that studio session, that was real. You can be real. But Oliver, it ain't even about picking a side or none of that, Oliver. You gonna have to just be you. I see you as a leader. Stop being a follower. Stop. The only reason I fought for us so much is because I know what I saw. And I know what I felt, and that's real. And Wayne will tell you, people will tell you. I wasn't too caught up in my shit to say, yes, I'm a free little kid, but I do miss my friend, because I know you can be real. It's time to be real. I don't want y'all to get this twisted. Me and Oliver, we were friends. But see, I saw some things that I didn't approve. I saw the wishy-washy, the back and forth, you know? So I had to separate and everything from that. I'm hoping that this was a real conversation. This was a real situation. Because let me tell you something.
I'll take a friend over a contract any day. I'm just ready to let everything go and just move on with my life.
I'm trying to end these bridges. I want my friends back. Can we move past all of this? Because that's all I want to do. Can we do that?
Sure.
Hey there. I miss you.
And I wish you the best of luck at everything, seriously. I think you're very talented. I think you have a very bright future.
I think the same too.
Criminal in the pain. Yes.
And somebody, you better go talk to your friend.
I'm gonna let everybody work on their own stuff.
Oliver Twist and T.S. LeKendra will never, ever have an issue. I'm gonna stay in my lane, in my world. Me and her can speak, we can talk, hell, we can possibly even one day collaborate if the check is right. I'm just saying, girl, you did write a whole song, this song around me. But it feels good knowing that her and I are finally placing the right step in the right direction.
Tell her to get my feet and apologize. Go tell her to get the lamp. Go tell
her. Lauryn just starts going crazy, y'all. I don't know how to say it. Walk around, sitting on countertops, waving this envelope around.
The bitch is messed up the line. She wanna lie to you, 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 she wanna make me a motherfucking problem. And bitch, you wanna motherfucking
get the line.
Cause listen, no, it ain't about going there. Let me tell you something. Miss Mom can't go to jail because she got home. You not gonna lie on me. No, we're not gonna lie. We're standing right here. No, because hey, she had things and this show is motherfucking boring without it. Truth be continued with a bitch ain't motherfucking here.
Weighing 376 pounds is shocking. And I'm comfortable with saying it. It was almost like we didn't talk about it or anything like that.
My girls!
I wanted to blame my parents, really. Especially my mother. I know why, you know, how I got here, but I guess I'm just upset that I didn't get here sooner.
So it's really up to you to take advantage of your journey for yourself.
I promise as long as I have breath in my body, I will not ever get back this large again. It's a little embarrassing. It's very emotional. Very, very emotional.
This is something you pray for. Did she find this within herself to do for herself?
I was smoking and I was overweight and I didn't know that my dad was not gonna be here anymore, but it makes me feel better that he's more proud than anything that I've decided to take control of my life.
You've been excited to tell your story?
Yeah, mm-hmm. It's been a long time coming.
Oh yeah.
Baby, last season ain't got nothing on season two. Let's go.
Man. I was only
that's not respect people's time. So let's talk about respect. Talk about respect.
Look, Devonte all out there with his titty out.
With his titty out.
Devonte.
No, he come on.
Titty out. Look like Trey.
I bet you have because you're fake.
Hey, Mark, this is Trey calling. Go ahead and leave.
You leaving?
Yeah.
The concert just was kind of like all over the place. I don't know if you're trying to use Black Lives Matter as a platform to get your music out there.
Boy, I don't do no running. It's your
I'm the type of person, if you say it, you need to say it to their face. Yeah.
Nobody has any personal vendetta. I was just saying there was no excuse for that situation that occurred.
I do not want to lose our friendship
Facts. Over
no BS.
Facts.
For real.
Are you serious? Like, I really ain't even got time for this, nor is it that big of a deal. Because again, baby, if you broke, just say that.
Like, you're really crying.
I'm just so proud of you. Like, it just looks really good.
But thank you.
And I'm glad that I got to experience that with y'all.
But thank you.
This show is like never before.
I know.
Do not record me. Where is G?
G?
season, I am very proud to say that I've showcased all I do. I'm a multifaceted content creator. I do music, I do graphics, I direct, I consult, I create, I film, I do a lot of shit, and it made me very proud to showcase fully, in its full form and power, everything that Oliver Twist is about and what he's trying to present to the world. You know, I decided to live my life in the public eye, and just as I'm excited to share with you guys my accomplishments and my success, I also have to be man up and take responsibility for things that I don't do right all the time. And that's okay, as long as I have people in my corner who are rooting for me, championing for me, and most importantly, correcting me when I'm wrong, I should be fine. And it's like, I got my boyfriend, I have a booming career right now, I got my friends back, I'm at peace with my sworn enemy. It's like, now Oliver Twist is transitioning into some bigger arenas and some bigger things. Listen, I can't tell you guys everything right now, but just know that the ink has dried, the cameras have rolled, and all I gotta say is, bitch, make sure your cable bill is paid, honey, cuz. The nerd ain't stopping, baby. It's steady up and up from here. Up and up.
For you, I put my lighter in the air for you. I see what you're doing, yeah, I see what you go through. Put my lighter in the air, the truth is you're beautiful, 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 beautiful.
To start off, I'm extremely grateful for this opportunity to be in front of all these people, giving all of me to you. I met Oliver, I had some issues with him, we talked about it. I met Lauryn, girl, we got into some things. We got past it. But some of these girls, I'm done with them from the jump to the back. Bitch, we're done from here on out. But I'm happy I've met so many great people on this cast. I've met Riko. I've met Troy. We are brothers at this point. Cameron already knew him, bitch. Ain't shit gonna change because that's the real ass bitch I am. One thing I can say about being a part of all of this, I'm watching my dreams happen before my eyes. And a part of that is being able to propose to my amazing boyfriend. We started from the bottom, but bitch, now we here. Rings on our finger, we're moving forward, bigger and better. Bitch, stronger and better. Outside of my relationship, there's so many things that Dominique have coming in 2021. I'm going out to Hollywood. I can't speak on what the fuck I'll be out there for, but I'm on contract. NDAs all over the place. So this face is gonna be on the screen near you very soon. I'm here to stay. Bitch, you know my name. And I'm over and out. 2021, watch out, bitch, cause the Reedy Williams, we coming for your ass, bitch.
For you, I put my lighter in the air for you. I see what you're doing, yeah, I see what you go through. Put my lighter in the air, the truth is you're beautiful, beautiful.
So y'all, this year has been nothing but amazing for me. I found new friends. Of course, me and Dominique have grown such a close relationship. You know, we're definitely the freaking frat of the group. I think that this year I've grown into myself more. I feel like being in front of all these people and these creatives and seeing how they act and what they're doing, how hard they're going for themselves, it always motivates me to go harder. I got into a brawl, but it didn't change who I am as a person. It only made me better and it only let me know that I need to, you know, take responsibility for things that I've done, which I did. And it also just shows me that anything can happen at any moment, but you gotta know how to control yourself. I am just really mostly excited that I actually have found something that I want to do. And I found Talk Like Tuesdays, of course, and really just putting that brand out there and making it to something that I want it to be. You know, I see myself being a mixture of, you know, Wendy Williams one day and a little bit of Jimmy Kimmel, but at nighttime, a little mess, but a kiki and a lot of fun. I'm just overly excited about what's next to come for Touch by Tag. You know, your boy Troy is gonna always do what he gotta do. I'm out here with these girls running around in circles, but guess what? We gonna figure it out one day. I'm just happy to be a part of the number. Listen, you already know what it is. It's your boy Troy, and listen, we already know what we came to do. Boom!
For you, I put my lighter in the air for you. I see what you're doing, yeah, I see what you go through. Put my lighter in the air, the truth is you're beautiful, 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 beautiful.
So this year, this past year, has been crazy. Coronavirus, my mother in and out of the hospital, being in a relationship and then getting my heart broken. Going through my label woes, you know, because I was going through a lot with that situation. Just like there has been so much adversity
As a man, I have grown so much because I'm still standing to this day. I'm still able to put a smile on my face and know that I am okay. I just want to say thank you to this group because y'all really have opened my eyes to a lot. I feel more me by being around y'all. Y'all are crazy, a mess, shady, but y'all are also very lovable. But most importantly, I want to say thank you to this platform because it has helped me in ways, you know, that I wouldn't have even fathomed. Like, my father is Muslim. He is totally against the gay lifestyle. However, by him watching, you know, me on this platform, he tells me, you know, hey, like, I'm totally against it. You're my son, I support you, but I really love how you're doing what you're doing. And that to me means the world. You feel what I'm saying? Like, I just feel like I've grown a lot, y'all. There's offers on the table. There are things on the table that I'm really excited for you guys to see. I'm not going to speak on it right now at this moment, but just know that Riko with the K is here and he ain't going no motherfucking where. So y'all can tell that motherfucker that be hating. Nah, I ain't even going to do that. See, it's not about the negativity, y'all. It's all about the positivity. Okay, focus on that. Be optimistic. Focus on your goals. Focus on yourself. Don't be worried about no hating ass bitch because they don't pay your bills and they don't wipe your ass.
For you, I see what you're doing, I see what you go through.
So this year has been absolutely crazy, from the pandemic, shit, being in the house quarantine for so long, and just me coming back around the group. I mean, it's just been drama filled, but overall, my overall experience with everyone, I'm glad to gain a couple of new friends, genuine friends in fact. But the experience was good. I don't take anything back that I've done. I don't regret a lot of things, and none of this stuff that I did in this group, I don't regret. I'm just gonna keep pushing. One day, hopefully I have my own club, you know, so I can do my own thing, but I'm just excited about this new business venture. I know it's gonna be benefiting a lot of people that I'm trying to help out within our community. And hopefully I'll find a bae along the way. I am looking for love, so if y'all find anybody, you know, pointing to my direction, no hoes. None of that, but you know, I'm just excited. I'm looking forward to the future and what is gonna come for me.
You are in the air for you. I see what you're doing, I see what you go through.
This year has been trying. I've went through so much, from losing my job due to the pandemic, losing my grandmother, losing my grandfather. I just had so many losses. And I did not know how I was going to overcome everything. Poor God! Everything is turning back around in my favor. I am excited. I am back on the radio. I'm doing what I love. I took a long break, but guess what? I'm doing what I love. I'm passionate about it. I've met a lot of great people. I've seen a lot of things, but I never forgot where I came from. Hallelujah. But listen, I'm super duper excited. It's been a fun journey. Get to know people. I hope I've been able to kind of bring people and mend broken things with different people. But right now, I got to focus on me and baby. It is the one, the only Moofred Hammock, the shrimp lover, that $30 plate. The Travis will represent the big and tall section all across the world. Hey, I gotta go.
For you, I'm lighter in the air for you. I see what you're doing, yeah, I see what you go through. Put my lighter in the air. The truth is, you're beautiful, beautiful.
As I look back over 2020, and I just realize how this year I was just trying to be focused. I was trying to, you know, stay away from negative things and things that didn't mean me no good. And when I'm trying to do that, people would like to make it seem like you're the problem when you're not the problem. And so right now I'm in the gym because I'm transitioning. I have to get ready for these surgeries. I have to get ready for this music that's coming out. And most of all, my single The Funny Remix featuring DJ Chose is taking Lauryn England to a whole nother level. And so I have to get ready for that. And I don't have time for bullshit. And so right now in this moment and in this chapter and in this new journey that I'm on, I'm just trying to prepare for greater and just trying to get focused and get Lauryn to a higher level that she know that she can get to without the bullshit.
See what you go through. Put my lighter in the air. The truth is, you're beautiful. Beautiful.
I
know that this has been a crazy ride and a crazy year for your boy. I have just encountered and endured so much. The police brutality, me falling out of friendship that I thought that would last forever. On top of that, I lost one of the biggest supporters who I knew, one of my closest friends, Taka Tour. I miss you so much. And losing you literally ripped my heart out of my chest. And with that being said, I was in a low place in Atlanta. I lost, including myself. And now that I have completed and accomplished some amazing things in the Atlanta area, I'm ready to take what I've learned, the hustle, the grind, and take my dreams and aspirations to the next level and open the doors for others. I'm excited to chase LA.
I tell you, this is one of the biggest days ever for me. I can just only look back at how I started, like from when I got out and sitting there talking to Wayne and just going from there, addressing everybody, making the music, getting people together, speaking my mind, even the fight, coming back from the fight, talking about the trans lives and how we matter. Just moving on through everything, I am really growing, and I am proud of that. I hope y'all saw my growth. But today, I'm kind of back at the start. It's a chance I can go back to jail today. It's a chance I can go home. But either or, I've done my work. I put it in. I addressed everybody that I wanted to address. I spoke my mind, and I got help. It's in God's hands. Did my part. I'm sad right now because me walking in this building, this could be the last time I see everybody, you know? I'm just trying to be strong. And I love my sister so much. I love Wayne, and he rode this ride with me. Like, we did this together. And I just hope everything goes well. I really do.
Lord, y'all, ain't no feeling like being free.
Guess what? Your bitch won. I'm done. I'm free. I'm ready to move on with my life. 2020, it was wartime. Y'all saw that for yourself. But 2021, it's tour time. I want to reach, I want to see, and I want to meet my fans that roll with me. I want to perform for them. I want to show them that I am stronger and I'm better. This is for y'all. I owe y'all now. Tour is coming. Lil Kendra chasing the fame. This is for y'all. I love y'all. And thank y'all for riding and rocking with your girl.
For you, I put my lighter in the air for you. I see what you're doing, yeah, I see what you go through.
Riko, we enjoyed you all this season. On behalf of Chasing Atlanta, mainly myself,
we'll think about laying you back next week. And that's a cut.
Buy a pair of heels that you can fit.
I say with protection.
Ooh, and it's a magnum, so she'll... Well, that's it. Look, if it's tiny, she'll want it. Girl from the state, period.
Thank you.
Why can't y'all just imagine Lauryn Country Bama ass with new titties teeth walking through China? Like, you know what I'm saying?
So tell us about yourself.
I'm the baddest bitch in Atlanta. These hoes soon finna find out. I don't know what they been thinking, but baby, it's gonna be a swish in the atmosphere real soon.
Hello everybody, this is your boy Riko with the K. Make sure you subscribe to Everything Chasing Atlanta, the YouTube channel, the Instagram channel, the on Facebook. Just get it all! Because we coming and we taking over. It's the number one LGBTQ show in the whole time of the world on YouTube, and you can't do nothing about it. Period!
Trying to follow my dream.